lose
if you wanna.
If you change your mind, well, that's the way it goes. But I'm gonna keep your jeans and your old black hat, 'cause I wanna, they look good on me. You're never gonna get them back. At least not today, not today, not today. 'Cause if it's over, let it go. But I've heard enough. Thank you, you made my mind up for me when you started to ignore me. Do you see a single tear? It isn't gonna happen here. At least not today, not today, not today. 'Cause if it's over, let it go.
If you lose the moment, you may.
going to work.
Hi guys, how are you?
Hey you guys, I'm Hillary Duff and I'm spending the day with AOL and we're taping in the studio, Sessions at AOL. I saw a list of the people that have done this before and I was like, oh my gosh, that's so cool. It's like all my favorite people. So I'm in good company.
I'm ready, ready.
The song Little Voice that I did today is a song for my album. Like high energy and upbeat, and it's all talking about her conscience and how her conscience keeps her out of trouble. I think kids should really look up to people that have made a really big difference in the world. And it's okay for them to like me and this, that, and the other, and of course I love that. I recently, last year, did an event with Nelson Mandela, and he has done so much to change the world, so I think kids should, you know, look up to someone that's made a drastic difference. The Jackson 5 and Led Zeppelin recorded here. I would never want to have to choose between acting or singing. I love to do both. And actually about 4 or 5 months ago, I probably would have been like acting. But then after when we started to go into the studio more and putting my album together, I was like in love. So I never want to choose. I love singing. I love acting.
Like the thing, and she's like big, and she's like, boom.
Like, people say like, I don't want to be a role model. I don't want to be a role model. But you know, that's kind of what their job when they get into this is, you have to set a positive image. You have to set the example. Well, one of the songs that I'm doing today is called So Yesterday. I think it's total like girl empowerment song because it's talking about getting over a boyfriend, obviously, and she talks about how he's changed all these things and it kind of makes her upset, but it's still yesterday. She's over it, she's done, and she can forget about him and move on.
I'm gonna be okay.
One of the songs that I'm doing today is called So Yesterday, and it's my single, so it's really fun, and I think it's total like girl empowerment song because it's talking about getting over a boyfriend, obviously, and it says you can change your life and you can change your clothes and you can change your mind, and then she talks about how he's changed all these things and it kind of makes her upset, but you know, it's so yesterday, she's over it, she's done, and she can forget about him and move on.
You could change your clothes
if you wanna.
If you change your mind, well, that's the way it goes. But I'm gonna keep your jeans and your old black hat, cause I wanna. They look good on me. You're never gonna get them back. At least not today, not today, not today. Cause if it's over, let it go. But I've heard enough. Thank you, you made my mind up for me. When you started to ignore me, do you see a single tear? It isn't gonna happen here. At least not today, not today, not today.
also doing a song called Little Voice, and it's so much fun because it's really like high energy and upbeat, and it's all talking about her conscience and how her conscience keeps her out of trouble. So it's very fun. I'm Hilary Duff, and this is the making of my video for Why Not. It was the very first video that I had ever shot before, and it was so cool because I got to have my band there, and we were on a really cool location and awesome sets, and it was great, so come take a look. We actually got to shoot on the top of a building in downtown LA, which was really fun, and felt really like free up there. There was just nothing but like sky, and then you could see all the top of the building, so it was really cool being up there. Oh my gosh, well, getting to the location for the video shoot was a little difficult. You have to go up like this freight elevator, and it was like a crazy ride up there, and the elevator was like shaking and stuff, and then you have to walk across this like plank to get to the set. And it was definitely an adventure. It was a little scary, but it was cool.
Okay, so Hilary, so you're just vibing. We're gonna do the first verse.
You think you're going nowhere when you're walking down the street, acting like you just don't care, but life could be so sweet.
We went through a couple days of trying to find the right thing, and I couldn't figure out if I wanted to wear color or black, which I ended up wearing, and it took a lot of people, you know, being like, no, you can't wear that, yeah, you can wear this, ooh, I don't like that, I like that, picky, everyone was really picky, and I was being really picky,
Do you approve this shirt?
It's approved. You have my word.
We all finally agreed on this at the end, and it was a really cool shirt that it was black long sleeves and it has like these holes in it, and actually it was all my clothes that I wore, and I had my black Converse on and some satin diesel pants, so I loved my outfit in the end and it looked really good in the video.
Roll playback, roll camera!
Well, my video Why Not is basically about taking a chance with somebody that you really care about. And you might be a little scared at first, but if you don't, you'll really miss out. And also, it talks about, you know, taking chances, and it's kind of a risky song. You'll never get to heaven, or even to LA, if you don't believe there's a way. We had a great time shooting the video, and I think it really matched the song as well, too. Take yourself from the sky, why not? I decided to call the album Metamorphosis because it's a big change for me, and it's a big change for everybody else also. Lots of people know me as characters and stuff that I've played on TV, and it's really personal, and it's a good way for everybody to get to know more about Hillary. So it's called Metamorphosis for a change in me and everybody else. I hope a lot of my fans relate to the album, because even though I didn't write the songs on the album, I got to kind of talk with some of the writers and say, you know, I feel like this, or even if we were just listening to demos, I wanted to make sure that there was something in the song that related to my life. I have a really, really great record label and a really great music manager. So they're so cool about the songs that I pick and stuff. I think they really like my input. If I don't like a song or I don't feel comfortable singing it, they're like, cool, it's gone, because they know that I'm gonna be the one having to sing it over and over again. I worked with a writing and producing team called The Matrix, who I was so lucky to get to work with. They're really amazing. They did Avril Lavigne's album, and they did three songs for my album and many other things, so it was really fun being in the studio with them.
Hollywood Records brought Hillary to us and said that she was, you know, planning to make a record, and would we like to be involved, and we just thought she was amazing.
First we meet with the artists and we try to sort of get inside of their mind and see what's happening, where they've been, what they've done. And it's sort of a thing where we take a magnifying glass to what they're about, and we magnify everything that's great musically so that, you know, everyone out there can really lock into those magic moments that they have.
I'm always too late. I see the train leaving. I'm always laughing. When it's not cool to smile, I'm always aiming, but somehow keep missing.
There's lots of different sounds on the album. There's one song that sounds kind of like almost techno in a way, but it's a little bit mellow. And then there's some really like rock songs on it, and then there's some ballads, and it's a big mixture of stuff, so I had lots of fun.
Where did I go right?
Where Did I Go Right is obviously about a relationship, and it's really sweet because it kind of, you kind of get out of the song that this girl's stuck in a bad situation in her life where she's like, she doesn't really ever do anything right, she doesn't feel good about herself, and this person kind of is always there for her and makes her feel really good about herself. So it's definitely a love song, and what I really liked about it is that it's a slow ballad that has lots of emotion in it, but it's not like, oh, you left me, da da da, I'm crying, you know. You know what I mean? It's all a good message.
You know, she came in very prepared, and she just, you know, was so charismatic the way she entered the room, and it was just the vibe was happening when she was here, and it was really easy to work with her because you know, the energy was just positive.
I think she's a very charismatic front person. The camera loves her. She can deliver a song really well.
Recording an album is, it's been like a really great learning experience for me because I'm so used to like making movies or TV shows. So it's totally different. You listen to lots and lots of demo tapes and you pick the songs that you like and you work with the writers and you work with the producers and you go into the studio, usually at nighttime because your voice is better like in late afternoon and nighttime. After you've done pretty much all the song, then there's ad-libs and stuff you do, like little melodies and different things like that. When you're recording a song, it's a lot different than it looks because you never ever record it just straight through. It's chopped into little pieces, like you'll sing the verse and then maybe the second verse, and then you'll do the B section of the chorus or the hook or something. So it's all kind of chopped up into different parts. I worked with a guy named Chico Bennett who did the song Bootylicious for Destiny's Child and music for Madonna and lots of other people. I also worked with Charlie Midnight and a woman named Kara Diaguati. I totally like working with other people and seeing their work motive and how everybody works differently. Funny that to say, like, oh, I knew I could sing when, you know, it didn't really work out that way. Like I said, always, Haley is always the first one to start something. Like, she wanted to be an actress, so I did too. She wanted to be a singer, so I did too. And we always did it when we were younger because my mom knew we liked to do it. So when we took acting classes, we took singing classes and we sang at school in choir and stuff like that. And I didn't realize I really wanted to be a singer until just about a year and a half ago. My sister actually did two songs for the album. She did one called Sweet 16, which is a really fun song and totally relates to my life right now somehow.
I think it's hard for an actress to cross over into the pop world, but I think she's gonna do it very, very well.
Yeah, I think she's gonna do really well.
I love being in the studio because it's totally different than acting. You know, acting, you're always, when you're acting like somebody else, you're putting yourself in someone else's shoes and it's not about you at all. And when you're singing in the studio, it's all about you and it's really personal.
I do think she has a long career in the music business because her work ethic's amazing, and someone who has that kind of work ethic, it's like Madonna. They're very driven, they'll be around a long time.
The song Metamorphosis on my album, Chico Bennett did it, and Charlie Midnight wrote it, so they worked together. And it was the last song that I recorded for my album, and I loved it so much. And I was thinking, I was like, how are you gonna put that long of a word, metamorphosis, into a song? And it's so cool. And that song sounds, it's really like rock and it's got a really cool guitar in it, but my voice is kind of warped, so it's kind of like techno and, oh, I don't know how to explain it. It's really cool though. And it just talks about changing and how people evolve and change. you're singing in the studio and stuff, you're not really acting because you're not on camera or anything, but you know, you put as much emotion into it as you can. And so when you do the music video, it kind of brings, you know, you act and you sing at once. So that's kind of cool. Hey!
The concept was written by Chris Applebaum, who is our director, and it was just a very fun idea.
Flame Polaroid?
She takes photos of these people, a diverse group of people wearing this t-shirt, and she mails these unmarked letters back to him.
I play Hilary Duff's boyfriend, the hero.
So we're now actually at the set for a sequence where her ex-boyfriend, later on down in the story, comes out to his mailbox and finds these unmarked pieces of mail with these photographs of different weirdos wearing his favorite t-shirt.
This is called the hero shirt.
That's one of them.
The Polaroids that Hillary has been taking all day of his t-shirt on everybody else, it's the first time he discovers it. But we'll shoot that a couple times and show it in a couple different wardrobes, showing that it's happened over a period of time. We may, in fact, put her here too, dropping off a package and sort of ding-dong ditch and running away.
You want to go barefoot here?
Can we go barefoot?
Yeah. All right, great. It's Venice. Yeah, Venice, Italy.
I could have my shoes.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. Roll everything, please. We're rolling. Set and action.
You got it, busy.
You know, I think probably the most challenging thing is yet to be seen. I think we're really concerned about whether we're going to get a lot of people on the boardwalk and whether the crowds are going to be controllable.
I don't understand what's going on here.
Sure. Yeah, why not?
They're making plans.
Caution tape, too. We love you, Hillary!
Yeah, hi, guys! You guys got the papers?
Okay. Thank you so much.
He's done a lot of autographs.
Can I do that?
Yeah, let me grab that autograph.
Yes! Hi, guys! Hey,
so cute. She can be a model or something. Like, she is so cute. I love her style.
And it's good for kids these days. It's just, she's a good role model.
She's awesome. She acts really good.
I think she's really cute and personable and just, like, fun-loving. She's totally natural on camera, so it's really cool to watch.
Well, I like her music because it's really positive and you can dance around to it. It's a lot of fun.
It was so cool because getting to work with like all the people, my label, my manager, all the writers and producers, I got to have so much say on what I wanted the music to sound like or the words. I guess we kind of get in a fight on the beach and he goes into the water and leaves his bag of clothes and I'm like, what? That's so messed up, and I take all of his clothes.
People would have a hard time or a bad time with a breakup, but I think in what Hillary's doing is sort of like shrugging it off with a smile and saying, you missed your chance.
about making a music video is it's really, like, you get to work with lots of really cool people, and it's totally different than shooting a film. And the other thing is, it kind of makes you nervous in the beginning because you shoot out of sequence and you never really know how it's going to come together. So it's really cool at the end to see it put together and, you know, all the little magic tricks that they use.
Last shot of the day! Almost done!
Oh, oh, it's beautiful! Ah, it's the world famous photographer! Go ahead, take another shot. And... all right, everyone, that's it for Hillary!
You guys, I'm done, I'm wrapped. That's it. We're gonna be back on Sunday to finish up the last day, but we're wrapped on the beach. So I hope you guys had a good time because I sure did. And I'm gonna go do something fun. See you later.
We're here at the rehearsals for my new single called So Yesterday on the album Metamorphosis. And we're at the studio and I'm getting ready to work with the band and we're gonna put on a show for you. So come watch.
Brian and I, we just sat and listened to the song and just closed our eyes and figured out what we saw the artist doing. Listening to the lyrics, doing movement to the lyrics, depends on if the artist is a dancer or if she's just doing her own movement, so it's really catered to each artist. As a choreographer, you just don't want to choreograph to the lyrics or you just don't want to choreograph to the music. You want to interchange and intertwine and have dynamics in the song, so we use both.
Automatically, you want to use throw your shoulder up for that. So like try to more or less think of your elbow going up instead of your shoulder. Oh, don't think your elbow going up first instead of your shoulder.
Okay.
So it makes that illusion.
Right. So it's more or less like her hand on the mic and just certain hand movements that go along with the lyrics of the song and kind of jumping off the rise there of the drummer and just playing with her band.
Tomorrow I'm gonna grind you guys over and over and over again because I think that's really the best way to do it. Once the performances look great and the performances look great to the camera, then you get a good video. In this video, I think that Hillary's gonna be similar to the Hillary that everybody knows. A regular girl that is easily relatable.
We are rolling and play back!
Chris determines the look of the video with Omer, who I mentioned earlier, the director of photography. We've all worked together for a very long time. We've done videos together for about 2 years, the same crew all the way down to the PAs. So it's like a family in a sense. And so they have a very distinct look that they've worked out.
Chris lends himself toward fashion lighting for the women in the shoots. And he's very descriptive about what he wants the look to be. He likes the high fashion look, especially on the close-up shots.
Director Chris is so enthusiastic, I love it. Like, if he likes something, he's like, yeah, yeah, it's so funny. Hang on the couch and sing a little bit.
shot the second day of the video. We got to do lots of singing and dancing with the band, and my feet hurt really bad. Besides that, everything's gone really cool. It's been fun, but we've had a good time, so I hope you guys have too.
Okay, and cut.
And I'm spending the day with AOL, and we're taping in the studio sessions at AOL. I saw a list of the people that have done this before, and I was like, oh my gosh, that's so cool. It's like all my favorite people. So I'm in good company.
I'm ready, ready.
The song Little Voice that I did today is a song for my album. Like high energy and upbeat, and it's all talking about her conscience and how her conscience keeps her out of trouble. I think kids should really look up to people that have made a really big difference in the world. And it's okay for them to like me and this, that, and the other, and of course I love that. I recently, last year, did an event with Nelson Mandela, and he has done so much to change the world, so I think kids should, you know, look up to someone that's made a drastic difference. The Jackson 5 and Led Zeppelin recorded here. I would never want to have to choose between acting or singing. I love to do both. And actually about 4 or 5 months ago, I probably would have been like acting. But then after when we started to go into the studio more and putting my album together, I was like in love. So I never want to choose. I love singing. I love acting.
Like the thing, and she's like, wave, and she's like, boom.
People say like, I don't want to be a role model. I don't want to be a role model. But you know, that's kind of what their job when they get into this is, you have to set a positive image. You have to set the example. Well, one of the songs that I'm doing today is called So Yesterday. I think it's total like girl empowerment song because it's talking about getting over a boyfriend, obviously, and she talks about how he's changed all these things and it kind of makes her upset, but it's so yesterday. She's over it, she's done, and she can forget about him and move on. I'm gonna be okay.
Hi, hi, hi. Hilary Duff. I'm 11 years old. I'm with the Don Buchwald Agency, and I'm reading for Julia.
I'm excited for my album to come out because it's more me and it reflects how I feel and it's the kind of music that I love. One of the songs on my new album is called Anywhere But Here and I really love it. It's about kind of that first feeling you get when you really find someone that you like. There's another song on my album called Love Just Is. I think so many people can relate to it. Nothing's ever what it seems in your life or in your dreams. And it's not necessarily talking about a boy or a girl. It's just about love that you have for somebody or anything. I think a lot of people know me as Lizzie McGuire, and that's okay too, it's cool, you know? But this singing thing is more about me, it's how I feel, it's what I want to sing about, it's, you know, what I want other people to know about me. Uh-huh.